So, environmental pollution. So, what is the environmental pollution? First of all, what is the pollution? The unfavorable alternation of our surroundings. So, many definitions are there. As per our easy way of understanding, some of the definitions we will quote. So, the unfavorable alternation of our surroundings is called environmental pollution. Or excess discharge of any substance into the environment which affects the quality of it, which affects the quality of environment, which degrade the quality of environment, and it causes damage to health of human, plants, animals is called environmental pollution. The excess discharge of any substance as per limit, as per threshold limit into the environment, which affects the quality of environment in the sense air, water, soil, atmosphere, causes the damage to human living beings, not only human, all the living beings, including plants, is called the environmental pollution. The quality of environment means the quality of air, water, soil, our surroundings, entire surroundings. These are all affected by pollutants causing damage to human health. So it is pollution is in different forms based on pollutants which are generated by different various types of sources. So what is the source? How it is generating? Some examples: industrial pollutants, automobile, from the automobile exhaust, thermal products, thermal combustion, agricultural pollutants due to activities of agricultural activities, burning of agricultural waste, discard, everything. Industries, maybe chemical industries or cement industry, whatever it may be. Total environmental is affect on the earth due to these pollutants, but among that, air and water pollution is one of the greatest dangers nowadays. Because why? Why air and water? Suppose soil pollution is there and that particular area is affected. Soil pollution is there. So water pollution is there, entire that riverine ecosystem, entire that water body is affected from where it is starting and then where it is ending and then where it is entering to another ocean or whatever, sea, whatever. There is no limit. So entire water body is polluting. So what about here? There is no boundaries too. Suppose one river is polluted, that river is polluted, and then surrounding areas, then those people are, those who are utilizing that water, they will affect. What about air pollution? What about air pollution? Here, there is no boundary for air pollution. Once it is released in the atmosphere, it may enter, it may go to any place. So, we are thinking. So we are in, I mean, very a good, pleasant area. But from the industries and then from the crowd area, there is a lot of pollutants are entering into the atmosphere. They are circulating through air. Hence, air and water pollution is crucial, very crucial. They are, I mean, not only restricted to one district or one state, one nation. Entire globe is affected. Suppose only for riverine also some nations will be affected. Air pollution affect with entire globe, but it will be changing. So the contamination of air, water does not just affect the living beings only. Non-living things also negatively affected, adversely affected. So not only biotic factors, abiotic factors also affected a lot. Simple examples, acid rain. Acid rains are eating away many buildings, many historical monuments. Park, national parks. So air pollution is the single most reason, for various diseases associated with breathing trouble, everything. Air pollution. So air and water pollution is affect entire biodiversity. Whole biodiversity, entire environment. So what are the types of pollutants? Pollutants are broadly classified into three types. They are biodegradable, slowly degradable, non-degradable. Pollutants are broadly classified into three types: biodegradable, slowly degradable, non-degradable. You have to remember with their examples. First of all, what is the pollutant? So by which substance the quality of environment can disturb? By which material, which substance affect the environment, quality of the environment is known as pollutant. That is, that entire thing is known as environmental pollution. Substance, material, matter, whatever it may be, disturbing the environment, causing the harmful effects to the environment by presence of excess amount is known as pollutant. Excess as per desirable, as per threshold limit. These pollutants are broadly classified into biodegradable, slowly degradable, non-degradable. Biodegradable pollutants. The pollutants that can be rapidly decomposed by natural process are known as biodegradable pollutants. So these can be easily degradable, decomposed due to natural, bacteria, virus and then microbes. Discarding of vegetable matter, domestic sea waste, all these are biodegradable. So vegetables, paper waste. So hence, many times we are averring, don't use plastics only, jute bags, cloth bags, every time, we are averring the people, public, use the material which are easily degradable. Here I have to quote one simple example. Every time I'm using this bag, this is made with cloth bag. Since this bag is using for, cloth bag, this is using since 5 to 6 years back. Because why? I may not purchase any other bag. Why I'm using since 5 to 6 years back onwards? this bag is made with cloth, I mean cloth bag. So with this we can use, I mean, including water bottle, everything we can put. But what about, I mean, how many years it will be spare? I mean, how many years we can use that material? So if I can use that, I can continue to use that bag 5 years more. I started using that bag 5 years back onwards, maybe 10 years that lifespan, that cloth bag lifespan is 10 years. What about any other plastic material and then everything anybody is using? So after 1 year it may be spoiled. We can simply throwing into the environment. Lot of disturbance will be occurs. So while we are saying don't use plastic bags, don't use, I mean, any other material which are fabricated from, which are harmful to the environment, first we has to follow. So even many people is commenting to me, why madam is using that bag, I mean, since 5 years, or I mean many years. That is my concept towards environment. Don't waste, don't throw any material, any matter, simply after using 1 month or 1 year into the environment. It is very harmful. It is very dangerous situation, not only to us, entire biodiversity, entire biotic and then abiotic factors. Hence, now onwards, you can start to use yours, I mean, mainly jute bags or cloth bags. So the lifespan also good, at the same time they can easily degradable, decomposed, even though if we are throwing into the environment. Slowly degradable pollutants. The pollutants that can slowly decomposed by the natural process are called slowly degradable pollutants. Slowly degradable means at what lifespan? I suppose vegetable matter, it can be degraded by 10 days or 15 days or at least 1 month. Paper can be degraded by 15 days or 10 days by natural decomposition. So we can observe their degradation. But what about slowly degradable pollutants? Plastic, DDT, PHC. So all these can take some 100 years, 1000 years to degrade, completely degrade and then enter into the as their individual elements. Simply throwing off one plastic bag into the environment, it's a matter of 1 second, but to completely degrade that plastic matter, it will take more than 1000 years. Depends on the, I mean, quality and then what are the materials using in that. Even the burning also they may not degrade. Simply, actually, some by avoiding some dumping and then everything, some situations, unexpected situations somewhere. Plastic materials and then which are not degradable easily, they are burning, but it is also not degrading, not entering into the soil, I mean, as individual elements, completely not decomposed. Decomposing means they has to degrade as a individual elements, then easily absorbed by the soil as a useful product. Simply we are throwing into the throwing one plastic or anything, any material, so it will take some years together, 100 or 1000 years together. See the situation, our lifespan is less than 60, not more than 62. now, I mean, we are not assuring 62 also, present situation. But what about plastic? What is your simply we are throwing? So hence you has to. Every individual, everybody has to take aware that who has to conserve our environment. What about DDT? While it is preparing DDT, DDT, dichlorodiphenyl, trichloroethane, it is boon for, I mean, many for spraying in the municipal sewage plants and then water, outlet waters, wherever canals is there, from the domestic outlet waters and then, but immediately within 2 years, 3 years, it detected as a, I mean, many adverse effects. Due to that, I mean, like this synthesis of like this products is banned for Nobel Prize too. Because DDT, whenever it is invented, whenever it is synthesized, that is only think towards as a insecticide. But immediately there are adverse effects. Biomagnification, everything. After that, I mean, even Nobel Prize is banned for this kind of synthesis products for chemicals. BHC, hexachlorobenzene. This mainly used for the insecticides for the agriculture, BHC. So all these are slowly degradable. Means plastics depends on the manufacturing of the product. What is the product we are using? It will take, for completely degrading, it will take some 1,000 years. At least worst case, I mean some 100 years. DDT also, biomagnification, there is a lot of adverse effects. BHC, everything. Slowly degradable in the sense not within our lifespan. You have to remember it. This is very important. Degradable, biodegradable in the sense, I mean within months, within at least within a year. We can observe that degradation. But slowly degradable means it's not within our lifespan too. Hence, while we are throwing, while we are wasting, while we are sending some any kind of material into the environment, you can think, avoid throwing to the environment and dumping to the environment. Non-degradable pollutants, the pollutants, once they enter into the environment, they cannot be decomposed. That they cannot be decomposed by the natural process are called non-degradable pollutants. All the heavy metals, majority of the all the heavy metals, especially lead, mercury, nuclear waste products, arsenic, antimony, once these are entered into the environment, only biomagnification is going on. They never degrade, they never decompose. They are changing into the lifespan, life cycles, from, I mean, primary producers to primary consumers and then secondary consumers, wherever it is going on. Then bioaccumulation, biomagnification is very crucial thing, very adverse effect with non-degradable pollutants. Hence, as per this broad classification of pollutant means any material matter which enter into the environment and then adverse effect, which can produce adverse effect to the living things and non-living things, including animals, including human beings, is known as pollutants. So pollutants are broadly classified into biodegradable pollutants, slowly degradable pollutants, non-degradable pollutants. Hence, we have to use which can be used.